This is an original lithograph printed in the 1890s to advertise a Tom show, a theater production of Uncle Tom's Cabin. This poster was all ripped up, and we preserved it at Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to another edition of Poster Fix Studio. Today, a poster which is over 100 years old. And it's no wonder that a poster of that age would be in this condition, all ripped up. Actually, this Uncle Tom's Cabin poster is from the 1890s.
Well, when I got this poster, it was cut up into pieces.
The back appears to be clean of any tape or residue. But that's just a stain from old tape. So I'm gonna put this together on a linen backing. This screen has already been prepared with acid-free paper and cotton canvas. I've already mounted two circus posters to the screen, and I just have enough room over here to put Uncle Tom's Cabin.
Tom show. What is a Tom show? A Tom show is a theatrical presentation of the story Uncle Tom's Cabin. Uncle Tom's Cabin, or Life Among the Lowly, was an American anti-slavery novel by Harriet Beecher Stowe, published in 1852. The novel had a profound effect on attitudes towards African Americans and slavery in the U.S. and is said to have helped lay the groundwork for the Civil War. Even though Uncle Tom's Cabin was the best-selling novel of the 19th century, far more Americans of that time saw the story as a stage play or musical, rather than having read the book. Eric Lott, in his book Uncle Tomitudes, Racial Melodrama and Modes of Production, estimates that at least 3 million people saw these plays, 10 times the book's first year sales.
Now I'm gently pushing out the wheat paste. I'm also pushing out the excessive air pockets and leaving only a thin layer of wheat paste in there.
Given the lax copyright laws of the time, stage plays based on Uncle Tom's Cabin, known as Tom shows, began to appear while the novel was still being serialized. Stowe refused to authorize dramatization of her work because of her distrust of drama, although she eventually liked Aiken's version and, according to Frances Underwood, was delighted by Carolyn Howard's portrayal of Topsy. George L. Aiken's stage production was the most popular play in the U.S. and England for 75 years. Stowe's refusal to authorize a particular dramatic version left the field clear for any number of adaptations, some launched for various political reasons, and others as simply commercial theatrical ventures. All of the Tom shows appear to have incorporated elements of melodrama and blackface minstrelsy. These plays varied tremendously in their politics.
Well, I've got Uncle Tom's Cabin linen backed. So we're going to let this Uncle Tom's Cabin poster dry for a few days before we trim it down. It's sharing the screen with these other posters, and you will see all this get trimmed down after these commercial breaks, so don't go away.
Many of the productions featured demeaning racial caricatures of black people, while a number of productions also featured songs by Stephen Foster, including My Old Kentucky Home, Old Folks at Home, and Masses in the Cold, Cold Ground. The best known Tom shows were those of George Aiken. The version by Aiken is perhaps the best known stage adaptation released just a few months after the novel was published. The six-act behemoth also set an important precedent by being the first show on Broadway to stand on its own without the performance of other entertainments or any afterpiece. Most of Aiken's dialogue was taken verbatim from Stowe's novel, and his adaptation included the full musical numbers written by the producer, George C. Howard. Another legacy of Aiken's version is its reliance upon very different locations, all portrayed on the same stage. This reliance led to large sets and set a precedent for the future days of film by focusing on the stark and desperate situations of its characters. Aiken appealed to the emotions of his audiences. By combining this melodramatic approach with the content of Stowe's novel, Aiken helped to create a powerful visual indictment against the institution of slavery. The many stage variants of Uncle Tom's Cabin dominated Northern popular culture for several years during the 19th century, and the plays were still being performed in the early 20th century. Although Uncle Tom's Cabin has been adapted several times as a film, most of these movies were created during the silent era. This is Greves Litho Company, Milwaukee. There were many, many silent films made of Uncle Tom's Cabin, but no sound. Because of the continuing popularity of both the book and the Tom shows, audiences were already familiar with the characters and the plot, making it easier for the film to be understood without spoken words. There has been no Hollywood treatment since the end of the silent era. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. Thank you very much for coming along to the studio. Remember, at Poster Fix, we bring your vintage posters back to life.